Students in the Daytona State College Broadcast Television Production Associate of Science degree work as production crew members in the following program.
Welcome, everybody, to the baseball complex here on the campus of Daytona State College. It is an awesome day for America's pastime on this Thursday as St. Pete College, the Titans, come to town to face the Falcons out of Daytona State. And we welcome you, everybody, inside our state-of-the-art studio here on campus alongside the professor, Ted Sofianos. I'm Drew Felios. Perfect day for baseball in Daytona State. They make their season debut here on WDSC-TV. Ted, how excited are you for this one?
Not a bad way to start, but talk about it. That's bike week and baseball. I mean, who puts those two together, right, Drew? But I tell you, we got something going on today. We got a third rotation pitcher for St. Pete. Actually, the first, and for Daytona State, the first. So it's going to be interesting to watch these two pitchers kind of, you know, get together there on the pitch.
Yes. Certainly going to be exciting. St. Pete, look at the order with Jose Rangel leading off. Colton Pizzio will hit second. Diego Aponte third. Brett Wagner, Carlos Sanchez, and Andre Martinez, the meat of that order. And then at the bottom, you've got Ivan Markle, Paddy Hebda, and RJ Gutierrez, the center fielder, in the nine hole to try and turn it over. They got an outstanding head coach, too, as Oscar Espada leads this St. Pete Titans program, improving by the day. An outstanding year last year, and Ted, they're excited for this series with Daytona State.
Yeah, and Espada, you know, even though a little bit more new to the program, right, just his second year, Tim Tuma, right, to contrast that, 24 years here at Daytona State College. But I tell you, Espada has been making groundwork, has he not?
Take a look at the Daytona State defense. We'll start in the outfield with Adam Parzyk, Sebastian Grafmeyer, and Scotty Edwards across that line. Third baseman, Charlie Pellicer, Nate Canizero at short, Connor O'Sullivan at second, Xavier Lopez, Jackson Junia behind the plate, and Bryce Roth gets the start today for the Falcons. So Roth, the starting pitcher, and we are underway from Daytona. So excited you are with us. As the first pitch is a strike, Bryce Roth for Daytona State throwing. And how about the sharp pinstripe uniforms for the Falcons? Second one just a little bit high for ball one.
Yeah, I like those uniforms. They are real standouts, a little bit of a kind of a Yankees, right? Almost looking like there.
Jose Rangel with a big cut. That one fouled back, one ball, two strikes. Bryce Roth excited to get the ball today on WDSC-TV. He's got a great fastball, Ted. Also, we'll see a lot of change-ups. He is a big-time change-of-pace pitcher. There's one right there as it clips the corner.
Just as you mentioned it. Good call there, Drew. Yeah, I like how he started out with the heat on the inside. A lot of control you can see right now, folks, from home. Local product. Matter of fact, most of Daytona State's roster is from Florida. Couple from Ohio, Reynoldsburg and West Lafayette.
So two balls, two strikes. Roth delivering. And this one is hit hard to the shortstop. Nate Canizero comes over and takes care of it for Daytona State. And that's the first out of the game. So Nate Canizero at shortstop, a third-year player for the Falcons. Going to be counted on big time this year. Daytona State, they come in just over 500. 11-10 is the record. So getting out of the gates, kind of getting a feel for the upcoming season. It's still so early in this season. This team only going to get better as Colton Pizzio takes a breaking ball for a strike. And that pitch right there was humming.
That had some nasty sauce on it, did it not? That was spicy.
Ball misses just high. How about the new scheduling here on this level this year? Really something new, something different. All teams sort of adjusting to it as the bat just flies out of the hands of Pizzio for strike two. But Ted, interesting. So we've got this game today between these two teams, and then tomorrow off, they head to St. Pete on Saturday to play against St. Pete, Daytona State does, and two games, a doubleheader on Saturday. So now that's how the three-game series are played, with one day at the home side and then going on the road to the other away side, and the away team becomes the home team.
Right. I mean, and here you had to come all the way out here from St. Pete to see St. Pete play at Daytona State. And then, unfortunately, Drew, you're not working when you are in St. Pete when Daytona State has a doubleheader.
You had to remind me of all of it, didn't you? Big swing and a miss, Colton Pizzio. The first strikeout victim for Bryce Roth.
I tell you, I like Roth's control from the from the outset here in the first inning. You know, two out. One ground ball to short. Cannizzaro taking care of that, as you mentioned before. But Roth looking like he's in the driver's seat right now.
Big cut there. It's going to be fouled out of play.
Look at that pitch. You know, Drew, we called a soccer game not too long ago, and here I was as we opened up calling the darn thing a pitch, right? It's a baseball field, Sofianos. I mean, let's get it right. But honestly, it's in beautiful shape. You can see that they manicure that field. It is actually picture perfect. Good day for a cold lemonade in the stands, folks. Where are you? Let's come on out and see the Falcons play St. Pete, the Titans.
Yeah, just a perfect 72 degrees at the ballpark today. Diego Aponte standing in now. Two strikes the count, and he takes ball one there.
I like the thought process with the high heater. See if he's going to whiff at it. Had a thought about it, but backed off.
Just waves at that one, got a piece of it, and the count will stay 1-2.
Slicing it down that line there. Might be a lucky fan.
Daytona State rained out of their game on Tuesday. They were supposed to play at the Florida State College in Jacksonville. But weather took care of that, and excited to get this opportunity here today. Over to third, nicely done. Charlie Pellicer makes the throw, and it's a 1-2-3
no
inning
no hits, no errors,
for St.
No
Pete runs, College. Down in order. Daytona State, good stand on defense. Coming up to bat in just a moment. We get set for Daytona State to come up to bat here in the bottom of the first. Halifax Health, a proud supporter of Falcon Athletics, and they are the official healthcare provider for the Falcon Athletic Program. Halifax Health and Daytona State College, once again, hand in hand into 2024. Drew Felios, Ted Sofianos, so excited you're with us. The beautiful backdrop here, the ballpark here, some of the planes above as well. And fans continuing to come out to the ballpark here to watch this Daytona State baseball team play. Lots of talent this year on the roster. I'm excited to go through this order with Daytona State. They have got some bats. They've got power. They've got experience. And this lineup hungry today. Adam Parzyk to lead it off. Scotty Edwards in the two holes. Xavier Lopez and Nate Cannizzaro, the 3 and 4, will be absolutely huge. Connor O'Sullivan. Jackson Junia has been the biggest surprise in the lineup. He's the catcher. He's hitting 500 just off the charts. Sebastian Grafmeyer, the center fielder, full of speed. Brady Hamm, the DH. Yep. And Charlie Pellicer playing
folks,
third base.
Those folks you just mentioned, I mean, their on-base percentage is over 340 for most of them. I mean, their slugging percentage for the first three that you mentioned, it's over 500, Drew. That's pretty darn good.
There's Tim Tuma, our good friend. So good to see him. His 24th season here on campus at Daytona State, an absolute legend. We're talking about his old playing days at the old Florida State League back in the day. Al Lopez Park, the legendary ballpark in Tampa. He's 59 years old. He's got a lot of baseball ahead of him, and he has seen and experienced so much as well.
And how about his academic record with his scholar athletes? I mean, absolutely amazing. I mean, 13-time National Academic Team of the Year under Tim Toomer, more than half of the time that he's coached. That's no easy feat, Drew.
Coach Toomer's a gem. Daytona State, lucky to have him. See the guys ready to shine in front of the cameras today. Okay, Adam Parzyk to lead things off for Daytona State. And there's the defense for St. Pete. Hebda, Gutierrez, and Martinez in the outfield with Wagner, Rangel, Pizzio, the second baseman, and Aponte at first. Carlos Sanchez, the catcher today for St. Pete. And Braden Cochran, pitcher out of Seminole High School in the Tampa Bay area. The lefty throwing number 5.
Oh, yeah. And he right now has their best ERA amongst their pitchers. So he's the number 1 on rotation, and we got him here to watch on WDSC-TV.
So Parzyk takes one. He'll be just outside the zone for ball 1, 1-1. Adam Parzyk, 400 hitter last year, is a freshman, just had an outstanding campaign in 2023. Doesn't hit with a lot of power, Ted, but Coach Toomer says he is like our Pete Rose. Constant singles, a double every now and then as well. That's a good pitch, though.
Oh, that was nice.
By the starting pitcher, Cochran, for strike 2.
Yeah, 6 foot tall, 196 pounds, at, you know, for Parzyk, sophomore. Averaging 357.
Outside the zone. That time you'll notice, too, that this pitcher, Cochran, will throw from the stretch. You usually throw with this sort of delivery when there's runners on base. He decides to go with it when there's nobody on base. Interesting.
Yeah, certainly that's great for when there are people on, you know, base runners there.
Good job staying alive by Adam Parzyk.
Hear the planes going overhead. Got two airfields right nearby here, Emory Riddle, as well as DAB, Daytona Beach International Airport.
Parzyk able to hang in there, trying to work the count here in this at bat. Yeah. Scotty Edwards on deck here for Daytona State.
Good job keeping that alive. The one thing I don't hear, which I'm kind of glad, is the those throaty pipes from our Harleys that are all over town today. Up until Sunday, that's when it'll disperse finally.
2 balls, 2 strikes. That ball misses just low. Oh, Cochran wanted the punch out there, but Parzyk has now worked it to a full count.
That was a good call by the ump.
This is a vintage Parzyk at bat, though, Ted. He works the count. He's got that boxer mentality when he is in the box. And let's see if he can get on here for the Falcons. Takes a swing at this one. It's going to be popped up. Aponte under it. He's going to be called off. And it's Pizzio, Colton Pizzio, making the grab for out number 1.
Now, when you have that, like you said, that type of mentality, it's scrappy, right? And so when you see what he was going, I think he got the pitch that he wanted right there. And it just got a little bit under it to the second baseman, Pizzio. Reeled that one in.
Now it's Scotty Edwards' turn, sophomore out of Fort Myers. He'll take this one a little bit low. Edwards with an interesting story. Ted, imagine going to Coastal Carolina, one of the outstanding powerhouse programs in the country. Was ready to play, but then injured his shoulder. And it was a shoulder that kind of gave him some issues when he was in high school. So just not fully ready to contribute to the Chanticleers. So he kind of puts himself out there, becomes sort of a college free agent, so to speak. Daytona State picks him up. And he was recommended by Preston Heben, who is a current player on the Falcons roster. It seems like so many Daytona State players are guys that are recommended to Coach Toomer. There's a strike right down the pipe.
It's nice when you know, have players that are doing the scouting for you, Drew. Certainly helps the assistant coaches with that as well.
Two balls, one strike now. Good cut by Edwards, fouls it out. So Scotty Edwards, he is now recommitted, and he's plans to go to Davidson. So good news for him.
Yeah.
Give big-time college baseball another try after the tenure here at Daytona State. But the Falcons program is a landing pad for so much great talent around the country, and Edwards another example of that.
And with Tuma grooming them, of course. Oh, he had a good rip at that one. That'll kind of sit with him for a second. Just got that right elbow just a little bit low on the plane.
Xavier Lopez on deck here for Daytona State. Goose egg on the board in the top of the first for St. Pete. Falcons trying to do some damage here in their first at bat. These are long at bats for Parzik and Edwards, really making Cochran work.
You know, you stretch out a pitcher that much, I mean, you know, how many pitches can you throw before you're going to have to, you know, sub them out? Only one out right now. Even count.
And got him on the inside part of the plate. That's a dandy pitch from Cochran for out number two.
He painted the line right there on the inside of the plate. Gorgeous pitch right there. Tough one from the lefty.
Now batting.
Here it is again. Watch it just go right over the stripe. Ooh, maybe just a tad inside, but hey. Ump gave him a little bit larger of a plate that time.
Now Xavier Lopez turn. Lopez in the three hole takes one. Outside for ball one. Another player recommended to the program here, Xavier Lopez. Phil Enright is the pitching coach at Oviedo, is the one who said Lopez is ideal for the Falcons program. And here he is, had a big grand slam to beat Santa Fe a couple weeks back. This guy right here swinging a mean bat, Xavier Lopez.
And Santa Fe, I mean, with a really, you know, they're a top-heavy program. I mean, they got a lot of great players over there. Basically a feeder system right over to the University of Florida Gators, trying to show out themselves there at Santa Fe.
Two balls, one strike. Lopez got that confidence at the plate. Fouls one back, 2-2. Nate Canizero will be the next hitter for Daytona State if Xavier Lopez can get on. Lopez last year was quiet at the beginning of the season, Ted, and then Coach Tuma gave him an opportunity and he just erupted. Coach Tuma said, I probably should have stuck him into the game a little bit sooner. Lopez certainly proved he can play this game at this level.
Ooh, that was close. I was trying to see what the ump was saying there, but it is a full count, Drew.
Good start for Braden Cochran. St. Pete Titans lefty coming in here with a full count. Lopez with a little dribbler. Catcher's going to come out. Sanchez over to first. Well done.
That was a heck of a play.
So another 1-2-3 inning. Six batters up, six batters down. We've played an inning here in Daytona. St. Pete and your Falcons still scoreless. Have you seen a baseball park as photogenic as this one here at Daytona State? Beautiful grass field, just looking perfection today here on this Thursday. And, you know, it just so happens to be an outstanding photo program here at Daytona State as well. Ted, I'm trying to segue here. So
right. Yeah, well, I get you. I mean, you talk about, you know, Field of Dreams right there. You know, and then, of course, you have the South Museum of Photography, the SMP.
Okay.
Which is just a beautiful, gorgeous photography museum. Very few two-year programs can boast such a thing. Same thing here with WDSC-TV, my man.
Let's take a look at the photo program here at Daytona State.
The fact that it's very hands-on. I'm out shooting, I'm editing, I'm learning everything I possibly can, and I get to do what I love every single day.
The availability of the cameras, the lenses, the paper, having the printers available to print your pictures right away, it's such an amazing experience.
Daytona State makes me feel like I belong here because the faculty and the community that you create within this program is incredible.
That's a really nice, you know, really nice set right there. You know, talking about the photography program and hands-on students right there giving some of their testimonials, Drew.
Brett Wagner, first batter, pops out for St. Pete College. So one down here in the second. Carlos Sanchez stepping in. So much to offer here at this college, Daytona State. Ted, you come here for an education, you can literally pick the craft, pick the specialization, whatever it is you want, offering more than most universities here at Daytona State.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we'll definitely go into some of that later on, Drew, for sure, as we have time, as we normally do during a baseball game. You know, soccer and basketball, a little bit more frenetic and harder to kind of get those, you know, segues in there.
Stick the bat out there. It's popped up, should be caught. Center fielder comes over, Grafmeyer, to make the grab. So we have not had a base runner in this game so far. And there is two down. And how about the basketball team last night getting a big victory?
Now batting, right fielder,
wow.
Number 27.
Wow, you and I got to call a couple of those, and they are just incredible, right? I believe, Drew, if I'm saying this correctly, they're in the top five in the nation. Am I right in saying so? Yes, sir. Now, interesting, you know, as we're talking about baseball here, right? Andre Martinez up. Ooh, that looked close. Ooh. A little high.
Yeah, it was actually that game Monday night. Daytona State, from what I understand, was talking to Anita, our production manager, before this broadcast. Basketball team trailed the entire game, Ted, against Florida Southwestern State. Hit one at the buzzer to win it. They did not lead the entire game. Just in time to take it.
Jiminy.
How about that? Great story by Coach Cantons and the Falcons. This one delivered low, and you see Bryce Roth. He is in a groove right now for the Falcons.
Yeah, that had some dip in it. Not so linear. So the ump said, yep, that caught the strike zone.
Martinez watches one outside. Andre Martinez for St. Pete.
All right, what's he looking for here on a 3-2 full count?
He mashes it. Martinez out of Columbia has a home run for the Titans. So the international product goes yard here at Daytona. Boy, that swing, he looked like Manny Ramirez of the Boston Red Sox, man, when he got a piece of that one.
Did he turn the upper body and torque those hips? And that got out of here, Drew, in a hurry. But hey, nobody was on base, only 1-0. Here it is again, folks. And a rip. Woo! Yeah, he knew it. He said, oh, I can slow down now. Don't park your car over there, folks, okay? That could be trouble.
So, first run of the game to the Titans of St. Pete. Andre Martinez delivering. And now Ivan Markel is your hitter.
You know, with the Martinez home run there, I was saying to you, Drew, what do you think he's looking for? Well, we know what he was looking for. He was looking for the fastball down the pipe.
Yeah, he sat on it and just crushed it. Breaking ball outside.
So much nuance, right, between the catcher, pitcher, and the hitter. in baseball.
This ball is hit to the third baseman, Charlie Pelliser, again.
Wow.
Able to throw to first for out number three, but damage done for St. Pete. Andre Martinez, the solo home run, a 1-0 game as we go to the bottom of the second here on WDSC TV. Take a look at some season stats on both sides. St. Pete and Daytona State both have played 21 games. Better record owned by the Falcons at 11-10. Daytona State, again, they feel like their best baseball is certainly ahead of them. But in conference, you know how difficult it is just to win games in this conference, Ted. You run through the gauntlet, don't you?
Oh, yeah. I mean, so evenly matched in these two-year programs that they're playing against in Region 8. About, I believe, if I remember correctly, about 12 teams, including, of course, the Titans and Daytona State. On paper, you know, Daytona State, you know, might look just a tiny bit better. But like you were saying, this coach, right? This new coach, Espada, I mean, he's got some great, beginnings of a building program here for the Titans.
So Daytona State coming up here in the bottom of the second. And leading it off, it'll be Nate Canizzaro. Nate's a third-year player in Daytona State's program.
So here he is in the seventh spot.
The big kid. And that's a strike delivered by Cochran. Nate Canizzaro was a player that was discovered during COVID. You know how bizarre those recruiting days were. You couldn't make visits. Basically just kind of did it by video or by hearsay. Canizzaro takes a big wave at this one. It's hit to right field. And under it is Martinez for the first out.
Yeah, the wind is not blowing out to right field today.
The next batter, second baseman.
So it didn't get as
three,
much carry.
Connor O'Sullivan.
Second baseman Connor O'Sullivan. Now for Daytona State.
Freshman from Venice, Florida. Very, very few, like I mentioned before. I know that Titans have some players from Puerto Rico, two from Venezuela, both of them playing tonight. But certainly for DSC, a lot more local product from around the panhandle all the way down through southern Florida.
Two balls, no strikes here to O'Sullivan. Got a little bit of an unorthodox batting stance you see there from Connor as he watches it outside. This is also his third year here at Daytona State. He's been injured most of his time here on campus, so excited to finally get his opportunity and get on the field for the Falcons.
Right. He's batting .263 right now for DSC, the second baseman. Not bad as an average at all. His on-base percentage, though, it's much better.
And he becomes the first base runner for Daytona State. Aboard here with one out.
Just as I say that, look at that.
Now batting.
You wonder catcher, sometimes because of that kind of crouch stance that he has, it kind of messes with the pitcher a little bit.
So Sullivan will get a good lead at first. And Jackson Janilla, player I told you that was red hot for Daytona State. Here he is, the catcher, with a .500 average. Rarely do you see that. Jackson takes strike one.
Wow, that was a nice curve.
This guy right here has been the biggest surprise of this year for Daytona State. And Ted, you may be wondering, I know what you're wondering, Drew, if he's that good, how come he's not hitting higher in the lineup? Well, there's a reason for that. Coach Tuma kind of wants to keep him under wraps. You know, you don't want to wear him out. And players that are at the bottom of the order are pitched much differently, too, than guys at the top.
Right.
He wants them to be able to get his best cuts. Just as I say that, it's in the mitt, and it's strike three.
Yeah. Quick two outs there for the lefty.
The batter, center fielder,
Cochran.
Number four, Sebastian Grafmeyer.
So Sebastian Grafmeyer now steps in. Two outs here in the second. Daytona State trying to even things up.
Yeah, Grafmeyer, 6'2", 184. I like the way he holds the bat there and stares down that pitcher. I tell you, Cochran has really come out, you know, with some great location so far this afternoon. I love this studio, Drew, but I almost wish I was in the stands, you know, knocking back a hot dog and a soda. There he goes.
Grafmeyer's got wicked speed. Let's see if he can beat this throw at first. It's going to get there before he does. As the play made by Rangel, the shortstop, to take care of Daytona State in the second. So two innings in the books. St. Pete College leading 1-0. You're watching Falcons Baseball on WDSC-TV.
Halifax Health wants to help you find your new career in healthcare. See how at halifaxhealth.org/education.
My favorite part about the program at Daytona State College is the dark room and the stock room. There's a lot of resources available for students to check out. Knowing that the facilities were so great and that they still had a full dark room was really what drew me in here, being into analog film and the resurgence.
I love teaching the students here. They actually ask for extra class sessions, right? Like to meet me outside of school to learn more. I'm so fulfilled by it, yeah.
Welcome back, everybody. Drew Felios alongside the professor, Ted Sofianos, and our phenomenal crew here, our television crew here at WDSC-TV. Excited to bring you Daytona State baseball on this Thursday afternoon. You're looking at another program there at Daytona State as we look at Bryce Roth, the big right-hander for the Falcons on the mound so far, just giving up one run off that solo shot off the bat of Andre Martinez. Ted, you like the delivery of Roth here thus far. As Patty Hebda now steps in. Hebda takes it high. Ted, I know it's a busy week for you. You're talking about bike week. It's also exam week from what I understand.
Yes, for our A-term classes, which are basically 8-weekers, right? We're ending right now. And, you know, some folks have finals, but at the end of the day, sometimes the students might say, I've kind of put some work off. Here you go, prof. Here's some late work. And next thing you know, you're struggling to finish that before the grades are due. You try to mitigate that. And there's a walk to first base.
The next batter.
So Patty Hebda standing on first. R.J. Gutierrez now will step in.
Gutierrez.
Bryce Roth. Coach Tuma would like to get about 5 innings out of him. If he can get to that 5th inning, thinks it would be a very productive day for the sophomore Roth.
Yeah, very rarely in collegiate baseball do you see, you know, kind of like you see in the pros, like 6 or 7 innings, you know, that they're looking at the starter to go. I mean, this is much different. You don't want to end up with a Tommy John injury for sure. you know, by pushing too hard. You got one of the assistant coaches doing pitch count for sure.
RJ Gutierrez fouls it away.
Like that cut, though.
RJ Gutierrez standing in, sophomore out of Tampa. And here it comes from Bryce Roth, the 1-2. Another foul ball. Ted, I have to celebrate too. I got to tell you, I don't think I've ever done a broadcast here, WDSC-TV, watching an athlete that went to my high school. But this guy went to my alma mater. How about that? Leto High School in
How
Tampa.
How about that?
RJ Gutierrez, my new favorite player on the opposing team.
That's right.
Of course, all the Daytona State guys are my favorites.
Hey, that's pretty cool, though, when you see something like that from your alma mater. How'd you do in high school, Drew? I heard some things.
Another story. Big sweeping curveball. Gutierrez gets a piece of it, but it is right at the second baseman, O'Sullivan, for out number one. Ted, you want to hear a funny story?
Hit me. Hit me, man.
Right. I played baseball in high school, and my sophomore year, I did not get off the bench. Okay. Now, I was a basketball player too, so I was a pretty good basketball player, much better than baseball.
Okay.
So I was late coming over to the baseball team. Sophomore year, coach does put me in there for one at-bat as they try and throw down to second base, and a stolen base successful. And it just so happened, the best pitcher in the county, Danny Graves, who had a great major league career, was the guy out there throwing. So I got to hit against Danny Graves, one at bat, three strikes, back in the dugout.
I mean, there were no balls, were there?
There were no balls.
I mean, did you swing at anything?
It was
just kind of look.
It was good morning, good afternoon, and good
Goodbye.
Night. And that was my high school baseball career. Senior year, did not play. I just focused on the one sport. It's tough to do multi-sports.
Well, somebody's got to take care of the pine bench. You know, you kind of get some couple of rags and pine saw, you'll be fine.
Jose Rangel. Boy, no mercy from you today. Stepping in now for St. Pete, top of the order. Bryce Roth trying to keep the runner close at second.
That's all right, Drew. I mean, you know, my big success was chess club, okay? I'm kidding, Drew.
Big cut. Foul back. 2-1.
How about the boom mics? Huh? How about the boom mics? That's just a great job by the production crew here. I mean, you got everything just zoned in. You can hear the tapping of the bat. Just great audio work, folks.
Oh, nice pitch there for strike two, 2-2.
Yeah.
Falcons trying to get back to the dugout here.
And how about the pop of that glove? You know, at upwards of a high 80s sinker there.
Runner in scoring position here for St. Pete. That one high in the zone, now 3-2. It's a bevy of pitchers available today for Coach Tuma, but again, he wants Roth to try and go as deep in this game as he possibly can. Rangel takes another wave at it. It's hit to right field. Catch made out there as they throw to second, and everybody's safe. Scotty Edwards out there, though, running it down, tracking that ball and right for the second out.
Yeah, didn't seem to have too much trouble with that. As I said before, you know, the wind is not much of a factor today. It's absolutely gorgeous out there. And here's a replay of it. Kind of got it off the very end of the bat. Not going to get a lot of power with that. Just a good throw to second base. That's textbook right there.
And you see a visit to the mound here. Cameron Juergens, longtime pitching coach here at Daytona State, makes Coach Tim Tuma's head coaching job so much easier. Does such an awesome job with all the throwers for the Falcons.
Yeah, I wonder what he saw that he came out.
The batter, second baseman, number one, Colton.
So Colton Pizzio now comes up to the plate, and I think Coach Juergens maybe told Bryce Roth, hey, just settle down, let's get this guy right here and get out of this inning.
Oof.
Colton, a very crafty hitter here for the Titans.
There was one pitch that he threw that was, it was a hot pitch. It was high, though. And like you said, he might have just kind of said, hey, relax a little bit. You're kind of overthrowing, overextending that arm. Get back into your groove. Oh, that was a smart pitch, just a little bit inside, huh, Drew?
Yeah, brushed him off the plate just a bit. Diego Aponte is on deck here for St. Pete. Patty Hebda, the runner on second. They're trying to keep him close. Big sweeping curveball. They get a strike out of it, 2-1.
That almost mimicked a knuckler, the way that fell in there, dropped out of the sky.
Colton Pizzio. Pizzio pops it up.
Got a bit late on that.
Pizzio went to the same school as Gutierrez, Leto High. So the Falcons sending a couple players to St. Pete. Leto is the Falcons on the high school level, in case you were wondering, as that one's outside. And now 3-2. Yeah, it seems like Roth is overthrowing just a little bit here.
Yeah, and, obviously, yes, we know this. The runner on second base can be a distraction, but you just got to get it out of your head.
Runner goes. Big swing and a miss for strike three. So Bryce Roth with the perfect pitch at the perfect time. 1-0 your score. Head to the bottom of the third on WDSC TV. Had a chance to see Cam Jurgens, great assistant coach on the staff for Daytona State. We told you about Tim Tuma in his 24th season, the manager. How about a congratulations, though? Matt Swiderski, another outstanding assistant on Tuma's staff, just had his first child. He and his wife, congratulations to them, as Landon Swiderski comes into the world on Tuesday, Ted. So Matt, not at the game today. He's got a great excuse helping his wife. And he is the latest member of the Falcons family. How cool is that?
Well done. Well done, Matt. Good job. All right, if you're watching, with the little one in a little bundle of joy in your hands, we wish you well and all the very best. And that was a picture of right there. Good job. Good job, TSC crew.
And we thank Coach Tuma for sharing that picture with us. Able to get that blown up to show to our viewing audience. If you're watching locally here in Daytona, still plenty of time left in this game. Come out to the ballpark. Enjoy a nice afternoon. And also, this Daytona State team, they're heading this weekend, as I mentioned, to Clearwater to play a doubleheader on Saturday. Historic Jack Russell Stadium is the site. That's the old spring training ground for the Philadelphia Phillies.
You're full of tidbits today. Drew, very nice.
Braden Cochran keeping the Falcons lineup at bay so far. Impressive lefty Daytona State is seeing here today. Here's Brady Ham for Daytona State. Take strike one.
Nice looking pitch right there. I tell you, Cochran has just been motoring along here as we get to the bottom of the third.
The Ham is a guy who is in the regular rotation as a pitcher for Daytona State. Here he's swinging a bat today. So a multi-dimensional player. Ham has been as high as the number three starter for the Falcons in a three-game set. He'd be the guy to get the ball. Inside part of the plate there for ball two.
Yeah, Ham obviously being able to do it on both ends, pitching and hitting. Ham with one of the best ERAs of the pitching staff there, the 2.45. Not too shabby.
Drew Felios with Ted Sofianos Hope you're enjoying this one on team1sports.com or locally here on WDSC-TV.
My apologies, folks. I misspoke. I was thinking of Jake Gibson is the one that I was thinking of. And there it is, ham on base, but not with as good an ERA as batter, some of the other pitches, so I misspoke.
Number one, Charlie Pellicer.
Let's go to the nine hole here, Charlie Pellicer, before Daytona State will flip that order for the first time. Pellicer, the third baseman today. Perhaps a little bunt action here. And that one's going to be fouled back.
Probably should have just kind of taken that bat back. Let that one go.
Charlie Pellicer, part-time player here for Daytona State. He specializes in moving runners over, Ted. That's why he was squaring around to bunt there. He's going to try it again here. See if he can get this one down. Catcher is up. Oh, the ball gets by him. Throw to second. Not a good jump. And just waiting for him there to make the tag is Rangel for the first out. That is a tough one for the Falcons.
Yeah, I don't know if he slipped or got a bad jump. Not sure. But here it is from our DSC production crew. Yeah, that's just a darn good throw and a great tag. And he has to walk back in dejection to the dugout. So it's safe to say number one will not be bunting, right?
2-1 here to Pellicer. So Pellicer trying to get aboard here with one out, make up for a Falcon runner being thrown out here on the base pass. Charlie is as scrappy as they come. His third year in the program as well. And now a 3-1. Watches it high. So Charlie's going to be a base runner here as Daytona State still looking to get on the board here in the third.
Yeah, close match we got.
Fielder, number 19.
As baseball games go, so far a pitcher's duel that we've been witnessing on this glorious day with just, like I said, it is a field of dreams the way they've got that thing manicured.
Adam Parzyk, top of the order for Daytona State. Oh, what a pitch. Wow. Strike one right down the pipe. Braden Cochran coming out of the Seminole High School baseball program. That program has produced some big-time players over the years. Two strikes now to Parzyk. Gets a good piece of one. This is hit into right center field and hit hard for a base hit. Right into the gap. Falcons will now have runners on second and third as Parzyk slides into second base with a double.
Yeah, that was hit right down double alley right there. So there he sits atop second base. Just a nice even stroke at that.
The batter, right fielder.
Adam Parzyk described by Coach Tuma as our Pete Rose. Here's why.
Right.
Good contact, and just like Charlie Hustle himself.
Charlie Hustle.
Watch this slide.
Nice.
2-1 now for the Falcons with one out. Table is set for Scotty Edwards.
Yeah, Parzyk basically one out of every three chances he's going to get on base. Very close.
Just missed the zone. Tight strike zone right now. Ted, did you ever watch Pete Rose play?
Yes, I did. I mean, I was huge baseball. I was a Mets fan, so naturally the Mets played the Reds. No, they didn't. Sorry. That would be wrong. But the Yankees did. All right.
Another ball hit hard, and it's into the outfield for a base hit. One run is in, and here comes Parzyk for Daytona State. So the rally is on as Scotty Edwards comes through with one out, and the Falcons have their first lead of the day.
And that ties it up 1-1. Great chomp there. And a lot of base sense. I mean, it was definitely going to be a single, of course, but here it is.
Lopez.
Just put into the perfect spot. Runners digging all the way. Parzyk and standing up.
Yeah, I think that was safe to say that was a good double.
Two RBIs there.
Yeah, the left fielder, Hebda, I mean, he wouldn't have been able to throw him out at second, even if he didn't throw down to home.
Xavier Lopez's turn. Well, jammed him that time.
Poof.
Xavier Lopez has been playing well lately. I told you earlier in this broadcast, he actually hit a home run last week as well, off a 95 mile per hour left-hander.
Whew.
That Daytona State was facing. Coach Tuma said this guy was the real deal. And Lopez, no problem, just took him yard.
It's the first kind of crack in the armor we've seen in Cochran over these last three innings.
Gotta love this matchup here, lefty against lefty. Lopez gets a piece, just foul. You'll hear a lot of bikes in the background this week at Daytona. And Ted, did you come here on your bike today to WDSC, to the station?
Come on, Drew. I knew I was working with you. I was worried about, you know, the hair on TV and all that. I couldn't do the bike now.
Can't mess with the hair, right? It's got to be all in place. It's always immaculate, Ted.
But honestly, on the road, you know, there was quite a few out there, you know, coming down 95 from where I live and where I work. You know, we have six campuses here at Daytona State College, so I'm mostly based at the Flagler one, mostly.
Ball is hit into center field. Kind of a lazy pop-up this time. And it's going to drop out there just in front of the left fielder. So Hebda was coming over, just could not get to it in time. And Daytona State continues the rally here, first and third.
And only one out.
The batter, shortstop, number 28, Nate Canizero.
So it's a base hit for Lopez. And Nate Canizero now coming up to the dish. Yeah, Braden Cochran was in complete command of this lineup first time through, but second time through, different story. Falcons looking for more runs here. That one sails on him.
Tell you, Cochran was looking, that's a pitcher there, so smooth those first two innings, but just a little bit of an unraveling here. He's going to have to kind of gather himself.
Cochran throwing a lot of pitches here in this third inning. Hit hard, center field. This one continues to carry way to the warning track. Nate Canizero just destroying one.
Wow.
Daytona State scores two more, and they are busting this game open here in the third.
Yosa. He knew those were extra bases as he was running. Surprised that didn't get out of here. Daytona State showing off their offensive prowess here. Here it is again.
Just tracked it perfectly and launched it. Got the barrel right on the ball that time. The ball nearly left the ballpark, Ted.
Yeah, almost a ground rule double. Better that it wasn't.
was almost all the way to the Halifax building.
Yeah, just in the distance there. That's where the partnership exists between Daytona State College and Halifax
batter,
Health.
Second baseman.
For
number
the
three,
nursing program.
Connor
both
O'Sullivan.
The ASN and the BSN.
Now Connor O'Sullivan's turn. One out here for Daytona State. Four spot on the board for the Falcons. Good pitch.
Wow, that was gorgeous.
O'Sullivan started his college career at Stetson. Broke a collarbone there, had to redshirt. His college career got derailed, came here to Daytona State, injured again, hurt his throwing shoulder. So here's a guy that definitely values his time on the field, but he is like just a fountain of knowledge for baseball. Coach Tuma says anytime Connor O'Sullivan is next to him, just loves to talk about the game.
Nice job there. Getting Canizara back to the bag.
Oh, kind of crossed him up there. Got him to swing. And Connor O'Sullivan has got kind of a deal with Coach Tuma, Ted. He said, Coach, I want to grow a mustache. And O'Sullivan, I can't really tell. Is that mustache growing in? I think just a little bit. Coach Tuma says, if you make an error, you got to shave that stash. So O'Sullivan doing his best to keep that going. And right now, that bat working for him right down the line. It's going to be an RBI double for O'Sullivan. He's called safe at second.
Oh, man.
Right now, the stash is working for Connor.
Man, but did you see that frozen rope throw by Hebda? Almost caught him.
The batter, catcher, number 7, Jackson Janella.
Time for Jackson Janella. Struck out his first time up. Janella swinging first pitch this time. Ted, you know, you mentioned the airport close by. I feel like maybe we're hearing a lot more helicopters, airplanes in the air than usual, and I imagine that's due to bike week.
It's bike week and it's security.
Mm-hmm.
You got, you know, just a lot of, you know, great, whether it's a police force or, you know, various factions of the police force converging, making sure that folks stay safe. You also, though, just think about it this way. Your beach is going to be populated on a day like today. What does that mean? It means some of that buzzing that you hear, those are banner planes. One of my friends does that. And he's got his, you know, own business that does that, does very, very well, bringing those banners across, you know, the beach in a little Cessna.
5-1 lead for the Falcons of Daytona State. Jackson Janilla slices one to right field. Will this stay fair? It's run down there by the right fielder. He makes the grab, and runner able to tag up to third. So Connor O'Sullivan, good heads-up base running that time, as moving the runner was Janilla.
Yeah, I called him Canizara before. It's O'Sullivan.
The batter, center fielder.
So here you have it, folks. I mean, it's 5-1. Drew, remind the crowd who are watching, what is that rule when you get to, you know, so many runs and then, you know, into the innings?
Well, it's just a 4-run lead. I think at this point, I don't want to count out St. Pete just yet.
Oh, no, no, no.
Too talented a team.
Not at all. Not at all. But
there will be a run rule in effect if it does get to that point. Big swing and a miss there. Sebastian Grafmeyer is now the batter for Daytona State.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember that rule, Drew. Ten runs, that's right. Yeah. That's right.
Outside.
And we're nowhere near that, folks, so stay tuned.
Yeah, I don't believe this is going to be that type of game. Could be wrong.
Right now, just the home team showing a lot of strong bats for sure.
Sebastian Grafmeyer, lightning on the base pass for Daytona State. Watch him get down the line here. This is going to be a tough play at first,
wow,
and just no chance. Speed beats it out. It wins that time. And Connor O'Sullivan scores for Daytona State, so they add to their lead. And that is where speed in baseball hurts.
He was locomoting down the line. You saw him right here. I mean, he was puffing. He gets right out of that batter's box. As soon as he said, that's quick. And you see, he's got great speed moving those arms.
Number 17, Brady.
And great camera work, crew. Well done.
Coach Tuma said that Grafmeyer had the fastest 60-yard dash time he's ever seen as a coach. That's how fast that young man is. Here he is trying to get second base, and again, swiping the base pass. I mean, he is like a rabbit on the base pass.
Okay, so what's next? Is he taking third?
That 60 time, Ted, 6.18 seconds.
Ooh.
That is motoring.
Great outside pitch there. And best to take it.
Jackson Janio able to deliver for Daytona State, extending this inning. Here's Brady Ham's second at bat. Ham watches a strike, 1-2.
Wow, that was a nice pitch right there.
There is a possibility. We see Ham today throwing for the Falcons if it gets to that. But how about Daytona State? 6-1 lead here. All the runs produced in the third inning. Coach Tuma has a philosophy, Ted. When you're winning a game like this, go with your best arms. Get the win, no matter what.
Right, right.
If you're down big and losing, then there's no use wasting some of that best arm talent. This ball's chopped to the third baseman. Should be playable, and it is for St. Pete as Wagner over to Aponte for out number three.
Quite a
How
run.
How about Daytona State? Six runs in the third. And a 6-1 lead for the Falcons. You're watching Falcon Baseball on WDSC TV.
I chose to come to Daytona State College because I looked at their program, I liked their curriculum, and I was looking for a challenge. So that actually was my number one choice.
Daytona State College makes me feel like I belong here because the professors, really. They do a really good job at including the students, encouraging them to do their best, and really making all of us believe that we can do it. So.
I decided to go back to school and I chose nursing.
Welcome back, everybody. Falcons baseball on WDSC-TV, and how about that scoreboard? 6-1, Daytona State with the lead. Drew Felios with Ted Sofianos and our entire WDSC-TV crew put in the hard work today. Ted, and how about the nursing program here on campus?
Well, you know, they have an absolutely incredible rating as far as passing the T's test, right? Then as far as placement goes, they're over 97% last time I looked at figures. And that's just absolutely amazing. And of course, with the partnership that they have with Halifax Health, that's kind of a big deal.
Halifax Health is partnering with DSC to provide assistance for the education you need to start your healthcare career. Find out more at halifaxhealth.org/education-to-employment.
So there you have it, right? Number 11, Aponte, right, is up there. Streaming, right, on team1sports.com. I still have to catch one of those because I have not, you know, tried to link into that website, team1sports.com.
Diego Aponte lifts one to center field. Grafmeyer has got a long run to make, but the catch is made. It's made by the left fielder that time, Adam Parzyk, for the first out. Yeah, Team One Sports, a great website. You can actually look at different sports from smaller schools all around the country. It is really cool. And Daytona State proud to be in that network right now. So Bryce Roth still on the mound here for Daytona State. Told you he's going to try and go five. So far, so good here in the fourth. Just give it up a run.
Yeah, for the most part, I mean, really in control. He was bothered by that, you know, when the St. Pete had somebody on second base just a little bit, but ended up getting out of the inning with only one run. And boy, third inning ended up being an explosion for Daytona State with six. You don't usually see that. You don't usually see six runs in one inning. I don't care what brand of baseball you're looking at.
Brett Wagner's turn. He popped out his first time up. And he's got a 3-1 count here.
Yeah, he was taken all the way there.
Carlos Sanchez on deck here for St. Pete. Wagner takes ball four.
Thought he was going to come back at him. Dare it down the center. Dare him.
Now hit that. Catcher number eight, Carlos Sanchez.
So now Carlos Sanchez's turn. Take a big swing and a miss there.
The bottom dropped out of that sucker.
Sanchez, first year player. Kind of an undersized catcher. Definitely gritty gutty though for the Titans. And a strike dealt. This Daytona State team, very experienced this year. And also, Ted, Coach Tuma says they've got a lot more pitching than they normally do. So they're in good hands there in that department. And it's going to be interesting to see the arms that come in after Bryce Roth is through here today.
And I think, Drew, as a recruitment tool, having dormitories on campus, which is kind of a novel thing for most two-year programs, right? I mean, 4 years ago, you didn't have that. The college had contracts with, various apartment dwellings around the area of the college, the main campus, which is right off of International Speedway Boulevard.
Strikeout right there. So now two down. And Bryce Roth continues to cruise for Daytona State.
The batter, right fielder, number 27.
Sometimes when you get that 6-1 lead, though, and you know you got the offense behind you, it just allows you to relax, doesn't it?
Psychologically, it really just calms the nerves for sure, Drew. So, and now, you know, the college administration, its board, talking about another set of dorms.
Mm.
As this has been such a successful.
Talk about successful. Andre Martinez had that big home run last time up. So you know that Roth is going to pitch him very carefully here.
But definitely the dorms have been a successful asset here for the college. Woof.
Big curveball. I mean, it's got to be because you come to a school like this, so many schools are commuter schools, and this one's got that family environment,
right?
That community, that sense of you know, being a student athlete or just a student that wants to live on campus here, it's just adds a totally new dimension.
Yeah, interesting you say that, either a student or a student athlete. So you do have students, and I know one young lady that's going to the culinary program here at the Husseini Hospitality Center just across the way.
Andre Martinez pops this one up. This should be playable. Center fielder trying to dive for it. Can't get to it. So this is going to be another run here for St. Pete. How about Andre Martinez? Just that ball dropped in center like a grenade and able to manufacture one more run to make it a 6-2 game.
Yeah, that was just a bit lucky of where that dropped. Almost equidistant between the shortstop, the second baseman, and the center fielder.
Yvonne Markell.
Luckily, those two players did not collide too right there. Saw O'Sullivan there and Grafmeyer hustling after it. but still a four-run lead for the Falcons.
And, you know, Martinez also showing, you know, his baseball smarts, his acumen, right? You saw that the two players almost collided. He just kind of giddied up and made it to second with that aggressive slide.
So he's got both RBIs for St. Pete today. Andre Martinez wearing that big smile too, number 27. Standing on second, Ivan Markle. He is the hitter. Grounded out his last time up.
Oof, just a bit high. So got a little bit of a two-out rally here for the Titans.
2-1. Markle will foul it away.
Yeah, good deal late there on for Markle on that pitch. Pitch had some steam on it.
Got just a little bit overcast here. Started out with the bright sun. Do not have any showers in the area, so that's a good sign. Got a little bit cooler as well. 69, says the thermometer. And how about that pitch?
Oof.
The payoff pitch for Mr. Bryce Roth. Aside from pitching to Andre Martinez, he has dealt with everybody else pretty well. So 6-2, Daytona State over St. Pete. Let's go to the bottom of the fourth on WDSC TV. Well, a new thing with the baseball program here this year, Ted, definitely want to tell you about it.
Please.
Because it is the Dugout Club. If you love Falcon baseball and you want to show your support, you can become a member of the Dugout Club. For more information, go to the DSC Falcon Baseball website, the Dugout Club, in its first year of existence. And it's a perfect thing because you've got so many great alumni that have been a part of this program that have cheered it on in the past. Coach Tuma has been here for a quarter century, and it should be so exciting growing that family and bringing alumni back to the Dugout Club.
Right, yeah, sure. What a great way to kind of ring in that belongingness that Daytona State talks about. You see it in the ads before, and that's really something that is a mission statement almost here at Daytona State, because we really do believe that as they come here that they do belong, and we want to make sure that at the end of the day and when they do leave here that they do look at a two-year program as part of their alma mater background.
And it's about relationships too, guys you played with, student athletes you associated with, keeping in touch through the years, business contacts, friends.
Oh, yeah.
Just to have and keep in touch with. It is have so many purposes and such a great thing Daytona State is doing this year.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that it can really be such a powerful, what I would call networking device, right? For when you know, something like the Dugout Club or whatever type of alumni organizations, associations are out there. Because at the end of the day, you know, there's a heck of a lot of people that are trying that and vying for that same job that you may want. You know, having that leverage, having those relationships, that networking ability, it can go a long way, Drew.
Charlie Pellicer, third baseman here up for Daytona State. Charlie in the nine hole here today. Walked his last time up, so did a good job getting aboard.
How about that pitch though? Upper right quadrant of the strike zone. Just gorgeous on the inside.
And it was Charlie's walk that really started that rally for Daytona State. This is shot into center field, and it is trouble for the St. Pete defense. So Charlie aboard again. He's been on base twice today.
Interesting. I mean, you know, that's the second ball we've seen kind of drop out of the sky. Right. I mean, maybe the outfielders are playing just a little bit too far back.
Number 19.
And maybe it's a heavier atmosphere today. You know, that's what I always tell my friends in golf when my ball doesn't travel more than 200 yards in a drive. Must be the heavy atmosphere, Drew.
Few other things too. Adam Karczyk watches one inside.
How about an unorthodox swing that should not be looked at?
Yeah, that's
or imitated.
Definitely factoring into it.
There's the stats for Adam.
357 average. Swinging from the right side, and that's into left field for a base hit. Daytona State just seeing the ball right now beautifully.
Yeah, I mean, you don't want to see Cochran, you know, with another, you know, bottom of the fourth like it was with the third. You know, definitely you'll see the pitching coach come out and have a word, most likely, if that is to continue. And just as I say that, they are advancing the runners.
And that's going to do it for Braden Cochran. So the Titans wanted to have him go out there one more time, but obviously you get more runners on base, and you've got to eventually make a change. So St. Pete goes to their bullpen, and Christian Del Campo, another freshman out of Tampa, now will take the bump. Take a look at Oscar Espada right there. Second season at St. Pete College. Spent some time in Puerto Rico. Went to college at Iowa State. Graduated in 1999. Great manager for St. Pete. Now he gives the ball to this young man here, Christian Del Campo. He is a hard-throwing righty.
Got some good music there in the background. You grooving to it, I see there, Drew. So Campo, by the way, excellent with a 1.42 ERA. Earned run average, I apologize, with a 6.75 ERA. That is not the 1.42. Looking at the wrong column, folks.
Well, here at Daytona State College, the students can experience the Falcon Media Group Club, meeting Thursdays at 2 p.m. That's in Building 400. Stop by and learn about the video projects underway with the Falcon Media Group. Again, Thursdays, 2 p.m., Building 400. All things media at the Falcon Media Group. What a great opportunity that is here on campus.
Oh, to work with these seasoned veterans, learn the tricks of the trade.
Scotty Edwards swings at the first pitch. You know, there's so many areas of the media that you can work, have so many aspiring media prospects that will come to me, Ted, and ask me advice to get into the field. And I always tell them it's such a broad specter of things that you can do, from writing to photography to
camera work.
Yes, broadcasting, what I've had the pleasure of making a living doing. But I'll tell you what, I always tell those prospects this, it's not easy. It's hard work. You know, it's fun, but it definitely takes a lot of work, a lot of research, and it's certainly something that, you know, you certainly have to earn your keep.
Oh, Drew, you make it look so easy, Mr. Suave.
And it's anything but. Scotty Edwards now watches one.
When did you know? When did you know, Drew?
Great question.
This was going to be part of your normal career.
Great question. So I was in high school at Leto High in Tampa. And as you look at Edwards, want to get too far away from this game. 6-2 lead here for Daytona State. But this is good, I think, for all aspiring media people to hear. And I was asked to do the announcements for the school in the mornings during homeroom.
Sure.
And I really, really enjoyed it. It was really fun. Scotty Edwards watches one low, and the runners will advance here for Daytona State. The Falcons going to get another one on the board at 7-2. So, Ted, you have a chance to do the announcements. I always knew I love sports, okay?
Right.
I was obsessed with sports, and I loved listening to great sports commentators, as you look at Coach Tuma right there applauding on his Falcons. So all these things kind of came into one. I enjoyed the announcing. I love sports commentators. And then it just kind of got planted into my head. That ball is mashed into left field, and it is gone. Wow. Daytona State piling it on here in the fourth. A two-run shot, and it's 9-2.
Did that get out of here in a hurry?
Scotty Edwards, he had a sense that that was going to leave the ballpark as soon as he swung. You saw him kind of motor down to first with those hand gestures, and I think he felt it.
I think he wanted, he was trying to say, come on, stay in, stay in, stay in.
The batter, first baseman.
Watch this, just kind of directs the ball. Come on, come on.
Wow. A lot of offense being shown here by the Falcons. Yeah, Drew, you and I would have been competing in home run. Because maybe you were doing
the
announcing. Maybe you were doing the announcing. I was singing the Star Spangled Banner.
Singing,
sir.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah, can you imagine? I mean, that only lasted a week.
Sound system held up okay, Ted?
I didn't tell anybody I was doing it for the longest time. So I could hear the critics. You know,
9-2 count here. Xavier Lopez stepping in. Lopez had a base hit his last time up. One ball, two strikes here.
Oof. You're ahead in the pitch count there. You know, one ball, two strikes. You hate to throw one in the dirt and bounce it to the catcher. Can hear his buddies in the dugout. Wow, did not get the call on that. I thought that was right on the outside corner of the plate, but ump disagrees.
High, and that misses for ball four.
Well, you hate to lose that. You know, again, he was, you know, one ball, two strikes, and now he's on base. Yeah, that'll get your hat turned around quick.
Nate Canizero.
Nate Canizero's turn. There are no easy outs in this Daytona State lineup right now. They are feeling it here at home. Try to jam him that time. Canizero still able to get a piece. Nate had that two RBI double his last time up. He's a really big kid. Redshirted his first year, about 6'3". So Christian Del Campo trying to get somebody out here in this Falcon order. 0-2 pitch. This one is grooved to the shortstop. And was able to hit it right at him, so that'll be a pop out in the first out of the inning.
Lucky to go to the shortstop there. You mentioned he's 213 pounds, this young man.
The batter, you know, second 6'3". Baseman, number three.
Certainly been an outstanding part of the Falcons offense. So 9-2, bottom of the fourth only. Daytona State in this fourth inning. Been able to stretch it out even more so.
Xavier Lopez over there at first. Connor O'Sullivan. RBI double his last time up. He's been effective today. Oh, he is just grooving it right now. Everything he swings at just exploding off the bat. Another base hit.
Hit it so hard that he couldn't even get to third base. And good job by the right fielder there, Martinez, to get that over into the infield rather quickly.
Number seven,
so this is a conference game, folks.
Janella.
All right, between these two teams. And as I said before, the Region 8, which is Florida, for all the JUCO programs, NJCAA. Only one out and two men on base with third base vacant right now.
And this is going to be a balk. So the umpire comes in, says an illegal move made by the pitcher there. So Daytona State's going to benefit again and got another runner here 90 feet away.
Boy, that was like a bunt to get him over to second and third.
And this one in the dirt. Runner will hold up here. Jackson Jania has gotten stronger this year. Right now very comfortable in the bottom of the lineup, I mentioned, with that 500 average coming in. Coach Dumas said no plans to move him up in the order. Keep him right where he's at. Let him just swing away like this. Good piece of one. I think off the end of the bat, though, so playable out there. And a nice play made out there by Martinez.
Wow.
What a throw. Just has a hose.
Oh.
Tell you what, this guy, Andre Martinez, is a player for St. Pete.
Oh, my God.
Able to peg Xavier Lopez at the plate. So a run saved by St. Pete. And, Ted, how about this throw and right?
That is just absolutely amazing. He's just dead on. With, oh, my goodness, never had a chance. I mean, it was right to, you know, to at least test him. I don't think they'll test him again, Drew.
It's time to claim your career. Daytona State's newest certificate program in hospitality beverage science combines theory and practical hands-on instruction on a range of beverage production processes like craft brewing and wines. Learn how to pair wines and beer with appropriate food choices, produce various styles of beers and wines, as well as how to manage, merchandise, and market beverages. Call 386-506-4DSC or visit us online at daytonastate.edu.
College of Beverage Sciences, another great program offered here at Daytona State. Drew Felios with Ted Sofianos here. The Falcons back in the field. It's the top of the fifth inning.
And that beverage science program, I mean, that's got a buzz going in the Bi-County area here.
Leading off for the Titans, left fielder, number 15, Patty
Hepta now steps up. Ball lifted. Anytime talk about alcoholic beverages, want to remind everybody, always drink responsibly.
Sure. Sure, you know. students aren't sampling, by the way, as well.
Yes.
I mean, they're creating and, you know, they have people that do that, that come in from the community.
It certainly is an art form, isn't it?
Yes.
You talk about brewing your own beer. Really, really cool. That one just high.
No, it's an art. You know, you like they were talking about wine, you know what to pair food with and what wines. I mean, it's truly an art when, you know, when there's enology, which, you know, is the making of wine, science, winemaking, enology, or, you know, beer science or beverage science. I mean, it's, there's so much to it.
Bryce Roth, 3-1 pitch just outside the zone. Remember, this is the fifth inning. He wanted to get to this point, and let's see if Daytona State will stick with Roth, or will they make a change here? Number 13, again, has pitched well today. Coach Juergens, once again, I think this is one of those trips where he asks him, hey, are you okay? How do you
right.
feel?
Yep.
You saw him nod his head right there.
Yeah, I have a feeling he might be saying, hey, you know, just look like a few pitches there you're overthrowing. You know, settle down a little bit. And I'd like you to finish this fifth inning. What do you think? Looks like he's staying in there.
It's been fun watching him pitch today. Bryce Roth, right-hander, out of Seminole, Florida. Osceola High School represented. So interesting. Bryce Roth and the other starter for St. Pete coming from really the same area, Florida. Very baseball oriented Seminole, Florida, Pinellas County.
Oh, yeah. half has found a bit of trouble here in the top of the fifth, finding the strike zone.
And this may be it here. Yeah, when coach comes right back out of the dugout after two more pitches, clearly I think they've seen enough. But hopefully Bryce Roth has done enough, and he's certainly done his job today getting Daytona State, but clearly frustrated. I think he wanted to go a little bit longer, and it's always tough when you're a pitcher and coach comes in with the hook when you think you've got maybe a little bit left.
You know, I think that first talk also can be unsettling, you know, for the player. Like, hey, I feel just fine. You know, okay, I overthrew a couple of pitches. So then he comes out, he throws just two more, Drew, just two more pitches, and all of a sudden he gets yanked. Yeah, okay, I understand the frustration, for sure.
So new pitcher, Wyatt Mummert. Lefty is a freshman from Cockeysville, Maryland.
Now pitching for the Falcons.
Some time at Loyola Blakefield.
Wyatt Mummert.
6'3", though. So an impressive lefty, good size. Also other arms on the staff. Names we're going to be calling here the next few broadcasts. Tyler Borton is one. Jake Gibson, another. One of those sidearm guys that Daytona State is, you know, often familiar with. They love recruiting guys like that. Clay Hendry and Austin Harford. Saw him last year on a broadcast. Last year he got that big win over Central Florida Community College, a team that won the national championship in NJCAA.
And you don't have to put a stop clock, or I should say a stopwatch, on Mummert. I mean, he doesn't mess around. He gets right to it. You'll notice that when this batter for the Titans come up. They still on the state pitching right now. Needs to get that strike zone leveled. There it is. 3-1.
And the hitter is R.J. Gutierrez. Gutierrez popped out his last time up. Big swing and a miss there.
Ooh. That was a that was a golden apple right there that he had.
Hit hard, center field. And right at the defender for Daytona State, just in the perfect spot, Sebastian Grafmeyer.
Oh, that hurts, doesn't it, as a hitter? I mean, you hit a frozen rope out there, and it just goes right dialed into the center fielder.
He is aboard, though. It did. It bounced one time, Ted.
My bad.
So Grafmeyer was in the right spot to field it, but still, it drops for a base hit.
So a little rally here then by the Titans.
Daytona State knows that that seven-run lead not safe here. St. Pete with just too many talented bats. Jose Rangel at the plate. Lay one down. This is a beautiful bunt. Get the lead runner at first.
Good job there with the bunt to advance the runners. Now on second and third.
The batter, second baseman, number one, Colton Pizzio.
Colton Pizzio is up. Yep. Outside part of the plate with a big swing. Runners on second and third. Big opportunity here for St. Pete to get some runs here on the road. Remember, they're going to host Daytona State on Saturday in a doubleheader.
Yeah, these teams getting very familiar with one another. So can Mummert take Daytona State Falcons out of this little bit of a hole?
Yeah. took a little bit off that one for strike two.
I told you about Mummer before, Drew. You see, I mean, he wastes no time. I mean, you know, there's a six, maybe between 6 and 8 seconds. He's ready and it's out of his hands.
Oof. Starting to get into a real rhythm. Two balls, two strikes. Again, you got lots of cushion if you're Daytona State. 9-2 ball game. You're on your home field and you're on WDSC-TV. The bats are working today. So let your defense make a play. Oh, what a great play. Did he tag him out? I think he just missed him, it looks like. No, he did make the tag. And the Titans,
wow,
their lead runner will head back to the dugout. That was impressive. Charlie Pelliser. Let's take one more look. See how Pelliser made this play. Oh, just got there. I mean, that was... was tough to call.
They must have had a good angle on it to say that.
Ball hit to the second baseman. Is it going to get through? Oh, how about this play? A web gem for Connor O'Sullivan. O'Sullivan has been the MVP today with his bat and with his glove. Daytona State gets out of the jam. 9-2, everybody. No runs, let's go to the bottom of the fifth.
No errors. Two runners left on base. Midway through the fifth inning. Titans 2. Falcons.
There it is. He was sitting on the seat of his pants making that great throw to first base for the third out to retire the side.
Conference standings here on the Falcons Athletic Network. One through five right there. Daytona State outranking St. Pete by just two. Look at the season numbers there. Daytona State with the 11-10 record. St. Pete College coming in at 7-14. Mentioned the schedule, how it differs this year with Daytona State baseball. You know, conference play, Ted, actually started 2 weeks earlier this year than what it normally starts. Coach Tuma said that just didn't feel like he had a lot of time to get his team fully prepared, get the pitchers ready to face the great competition ahead. But here they are.
I wonder what the rationale was to start it 2 weeks earlier. Those are for the administrators, I assume, to know that.
Daytona State's had some great comebacks this year. They trailed 9-7 a couple weeks ago to Santa Fe and ended up hitting a grand slam, told you by Xavier Lopez, to win that game 13-9. Also, they trailed State College out of Manatee, 10-3 in that game. Came back and won 11-10.
Wow.
That was in the last series Daytona State was in. And our next game is March 9th. Doubleheader, 1 and 4 p.m. That's not our next broadcast, but that's when Daytona State will take the field. So if you're in the Clearwater area on Saturday, you may want to drop by Jack Russell. I'm going to swing by this Saturday, check out Coach Tuma and the guys. It's not too far from my house.
That sounds like a good idea. I'm sure you'll be welcomed.
Yep, maybe.
So we have a pitching change, Drew. We got number 14, Caden Brister, in there for the Titans.
Nice curveball, just froze the Daytona State batters. Sebastian Grafmeyer for out number one.
So this will be the third pitcher here for the Titans.
Number 17, Brady Ham.
Brister, 6'4", 205. A foreboding pitcher on the, you know, pitching from the mound there. Oof. That didn't move, Drew. That was a zinger.
Brady Hamm taking a strike. Hamm in the 8-hole today for Daytona State. Swings at that one, fouls it back.
Drew, favorite broadcaster of all time, please.
Man, that is a tough, tough call.
It's not Bob Uecker, huh?
May need a little thought on that one. Low. The 1-2 from Brister is fouled out of play to left field. You know, I think different broadcasters at different moments. It's tough to say there's one guy that I like head and shoulders over everybody else, because I think that different sports, different times, and there's another mean sinker by Caden Brister. And quickly, there's two away. Like, how can you beat Al Michaels calling hockey at the Olympics in 1980? You can't.
Do you believe in miracles?
Yeah, I thought that was special. I also think, as we take one more look at this one, already two strikeouts notched by Brister. I think Joe Buck, in modern day, working at Fox and now ESPN Monday Night Football, has had an unbelievable run, and he is amongst one of my favorites. His father, did I say Jack Buck? Joe Buck.
He said Joe.
Yeah,
he did
Joe
say
Buck.
Joe.
Yeah. His father, Jack Ooh. Buck, as that one is going to be worn by Charlie Pellicer. He'll trot down to first base, but his father was incredible. Jack Buck back in the day calling the World Series. So I loved watching him. I loved Vern Lundquist fielder, calling SEC nine, football for CBS.
Adam Harzik.
And I think Jim Nance is pretty special too at what he does.
I think for football, my favorite's got to be John Madden. Just got to say, just because he was, you know, here I am, you know, I'm the color guy, right? So as far as his color announcing, and what he did, you know, my new guy is Romo, as far as, you know, what he can do. Collingsworth, second best in that spot.
No runs, no hits, no errors.
No runs for Daytona State here.
At the end of the fifth inning.
And Daytona State, after five innings, leads 9-2 over St. Pete College. Drew Felios, Ted Sofianos, we love baseball because it just sort of has a calming effect, doesn't it? Outdoors here on campus at Daytona State, but we also like to talk about a lot of other things during the broadcast, as you can tell.
Yes, we do, Drew.
Daytona State College offers not only the most cultural diversity that I've seen, but it also gives you the opportunity to kind of explore throughout different programs. Some people have to go from one program to another to kind of just find their niche. They have so many different opportunities for just the every person. It's very affordable. Nursing's a level of exploration. Not only do you get to explore the different areas of nursing and aspects, but you get to help people at their most vulnerable state. Why would I not want to do nursing?
You can accelerate your education by taking advantage of the incredible opportunities offered through Halifax Health Partnership with Daytona State College. If you want a rewarding career in healthcare, find out how we can help at halifaxhealth.org/education-to-employment. Comfortable lead for Daytona State. But St. Pete not giving up anytime soon as we begin the sixth inning here on WDSC TV.
Yeah, I mean, Brister made light work of his pitching outing. Let's see what else he can do in the following innings. Mummert wasting no time, as I've mentioned before.
This is going to be lined into center field for a base hit. So good start here in the 6-4, the Titans.
Yeah, if I'm Mummert, I'm just a little disappointed about it because it was in a good spot. It was down and inside, maybe inside middle.
It's the first time Brett Wagner's been on base today.
Wagner golfed that one right out with an eye on second to steal.
Carlos Sanchez watches one outside. You're mentioning great announcers. I think we also should talk about who the best baseball announcer is all time, because this is just such a different sport and probably the most difficult one to call from start to finish. Drew Felios, Ted Sofianos, and our phenomenal crew here on campus at Daytona State. And Ted, I always love listening to the great Vin Scully.
Oh my, of course.
It was like beautiful music, baseball music, when you watched an LA Dodgers game.
He had a tone and just a slight nasalness to him in the way he spoke. You were just engaged just by how he went about it. His pace, his delivery, his knowledge, of course, Drew. Amazing, yes. You know, we haven't mentioned one of the ubiquitous greats, though. The all-around guy, the utility belt guy, Bob Costas.
Bob Costas, yes.
Yeah.
Great play-by-play guy as well. Love the game of baseball. And how about two base runners now for St. Pete, first and second here in the top of the sixth.
Fielder,
did you know, Drew, that Bob Costas is half Greek? All right.
Sure did.
Mm-hmm.
One of the great broadcasters come out of Syracuse. So many have come out of the Syracuse Newhouse School of Broadcasting. Mike Tirico, another, as one has popped up and out of play.
Ooh, so close.
So first and second, nobody out here. St. Pete hoping for a big inning, and this is the guy to deliver it. Andre Martinez has a home run today and also an RBI base hit. Big pitch there for a strike. He destroyed one in the second inning that left the ballpark in about a half second.
Yeah, you wonder if he's going to take something off of this one now. And he did.
Mm. Nasty pitch there for the strikeout. Just shows you what a lefty, a crafty lefty can do to a batter, a power batter like that.
Number 25, Yvonne.
One more look.
Oof. Nice changeup.
Ivan Markell. Got a ground out today.
Can Mummert pitch himself out of this?
Well, a big pitch there.
Got out one of the strongest hitters for the Titans, and now it's really heading the count here, 0-2.
And if Mummert can get out of this inning with no damage done, Daytona State has a slew of options in the seventh and eighth. Big time arms they can go to. Another strikeout, so he is rolling after putting the first two aboard. This young man has found something here.
Yeah, that was three pitches, by the way. Three pitch strikeout. And I think that lasted folks out there in TV land. I think that was about 18 seconds to have that out. Woo.
Wyatt Mummer just bringing it right now. Sometimes pitchers throw their best with runners on base.
Yeah.
You throw out of the stretch. It's a more natural movement, like he is doing right now.
See, I like this matchup. You know, lefty pitcher to a left-handed batter. And, you know, this is where a curve can really throw off the hitter. You get a nice bending curve. Looks like it might hit you. Let's see what he does. Oof.
Good eye that time by Patty Hebda. Patty was aboard his first time up, drew a base on balls. He's a freshman out of Sarasota. And he'll foul this one away. Today he's the left fielder for St. Pete.
Yeah, Mummert staying away from him. Pitching down and away right now to the left-handed hitter.
2-2. Wyatt Mummer trying to get back to the dugout here for Daytona State. Preserve this 9-2 lead.
just caught a tiny piece of the rawhide there.
See the catcher, Jackson Jania, offering the signals. Big payoff pitch, a strikeout. Wyatt Mummert, impressive for Daytona State. So he comes in the fifth, shuts the door there, does the same in the sixth. 9-2, the count. You're watching Falcons Baseball on WDSC-TV. And it's been quite a day for Daytona State pitchers as it started off with Bryce Roth. Braden Cochran for St. Pete throwing hard as well. Rotho going to work. Had that big sweeping curveball. This guy throwing some absolute gas. Oof. Caden Brister.
Oh, man. Bottom dropped out
there. I'm glad I'm not a hitter today.
Oh, we're watching some real pitching talent as far as that's, you know, just a great lineup of, you know, those strikeouts by the DSC crew for you at home to enjoy. Hear Queen in the background there, Drew. Great movie, by the way, about Freddie Mercury's life. Were you a Queen fan back in the day, Drew, huh?
How could you not be? Of course.
Of course.
How about the 10 hits from Daytona State today? Only 4 for St. Pete, so Daytona State swinging the bats awfully well as we move now to the bottom of the sixth inning.
But what about the productivity? Think about that. You know, 10 hits, 9 runs? That's a heck of a lot of productivity for just 10 hits. I have 9 runs, I mean. Came all at the right time in the right places.
Scotty Edwards to lead off the bottom of the sixth for the Falcons. This game has gone along too. We've had a lot more folks arrive at the ballpark, kind of a late arriving crowd, as the great Bob Uecker used to say.
Loved him. Loved him.
You got to bring up him when you talk about great baseball announcers.
Oh, yeah.
He was classic.
Yeah. And he could take some of those dull games, you know, that might be kind of droning on. And his color commentating, I mean, you just had to chuckle. You love the guy.
Scotty Edwards had that big RBI base hit. Get the rally going for Daytona State, but can't catch up to the curveball. And this Caden Brister has been impressive.
Yeah. Add that DSC crew to the strikeout highlight reel. Jimmy Cricks.
First baseman, number 25, Xavier Lopez.
Xavier Lopez's turn. Scotty Edwards has struck out twice today.
Man,
but again, delivered that big base hit.
I would have loved to have seen. Sorry, Drew. Would have loved to have seen a speed gun on that one. Yeah, that heat. Yep.
Xavier Lopez hitting from the left side.
Ooh!
Oh, it's going to wear one. So it hits him in the back.
Oh, my.
Ted, you okay over there?
You want to know why I groaned, if you really want to know. I was in Little League, and we were playing some sort of stupid game, and I didn't realize, there it is. I'm so glad it didn't hit him where I thought. I thought it hit him in the back of the rib, and that's where it hit me, and I lost all my wind and cried like a child, which I was. I was, you know, about 12. But I turned away because I got scared. That was like the stupidest thing I could have done.
See the staff, Coach Tuma, going to make sure that he is okay. Xavier Lopez, take a fastball right in the back. Certainly going to send some shockwaves throughout your entire body. But Lopez looks like he's okay.
Hey, he's saying I'm okay. It certainly didn't hit. I mean, if it hit him in the funny bone, he's going to be writhing in pain.
Now batting, shortstop, number 28.
So Xavier Lopez is one tough customer right there as he paves the way for Nate Canizero. Nate popped out his last time up. So Canizero's got a pop out, a double, and then another pop out. The double produced two RBIs earlier in this game.
Brister better watch out here. He's losing some control. And that's going to advance a runner to second. He's all of a sudden, Brister's just gotten a bit wild. Looked like he had the, you know, the full package going on for himself.
Two balls, no strikes. Canizero. Barron down here, and there's a strike on the outside part of the plate.
Yeah, that was a charity call there by the ump. Probably will help Brister get back into launching mode here.
Launched into the outfield, and it's going to drop right in the gap. Hit it in the perfect spot. Falcons going to run for days here. And again, Nate Canizero comes through, his second double of the day.
That's going to put up double digits for Daytona State, 10-2. Only the bottom of the sixth.
Nate Canizero recruited during COVID. Sometimes some of those COVID recruits, you wonder, didn't get a lot of FaceTime with any of those guys, but has Canizero ever come through for Daytona State? Cleanup hitter in this lineup. No signs of turning back. Connor O'Sullivan now the hitter.
O'Sullivan, crouching tiger stance. Right.
Like that stance, don't you?
Yeah.
Little chopper. This one going to be fielded by the second baseman, Pizzio. Over to first.
But that should move the runner over to Canizero, third base. So two outs.
The batter, catcher.
Man on third.
Number seven, Jackson Janilla.
And here's one player that you were talking about that, you know, down in the lineup there as far as hitting. And just a great standout, great addition for Tim Tuma.
Have not seen his best swing today. Let's see if we can get that now for Jackson. Just worked his way into that number one catcher spot.
Brister certainly struggling a bit more. I should say a good deal more than that other inning we saw, which was the fifth, where he just looked, you know, omnipotent. Yeah, right thing to do there, just take one.
Three balls, one strike to Jackson Janilla at a nearby St. Cloud. Went to Harmony High School. Chops one. And this is going to be a really tough play. It's into the outfield, and Janilla comes through with an RBI. 11-2 now. And Ted, you mentioned a potential run rule, and I laughed at you early in this game, but turns out you were onto something.
I'm just saying that the offense was being really strong here.
Yeah. Sebastian Grafmeyer now steps in.
Yeah, Brister is just getting a bit frustrated with himself. Don't do that. Keep your psyche in it. Stay positive.
Missed high that time. Three balls, two strikes.
Just high.
This guy's a handful to deal with. Sebastian Grafmeyer. He gets on base. Look out. Got that tremendous speed. And he'll foul this one away. So the run rule could very well be in effect here. And the ball gets away that time, so Grafmeyer heads to first base. So our research crew here at WDSC-TV doing a little research on the run rule this year. Sometimes it fluctuates. 8 runs after 7 innings, 10 runs after 8 innings. So St. Pete would be under pressure in the next at-bat to produce, or else this game could be over.
Right. And I was just checking. Ten runs after 5. I was just checking with the crew, and so if Daytona State here scores another run.
They don't need another. Well, no, they don't. I don't believe so.
No, I mean, the game would be over at the end of this inning then, Drew, is what I'm thinking. So the graphic you saw, folks, would mean that at the mid-seventh, when you normally have the seventh inning stretch, it would not occur.
This ball's lifted into left field. Brady Hamm, the batter right now for Daytona State. Yeah, the Falcons have just been relentless swinging the bat. They've had a good combo pitching combination working today. Bryce Roth, Wyatt Mummer teaming up. And St. Pete has just stranded some runners here over the last several innings. Looked like they were going to kind of make a rally, make a run. It just never really happened.
So for Daytona State, you got runners on first and second with 2 out.
Hamm watches one high, and now the bases are all loaded up.
They are amped.
So St. Pete going to get a little visit to the mound here. And Daytona State intent on perhaps hit the showers early.
Yeah, that would be one way to say it, Drew, for sure. It's a shame for Brister, though. He was looking so darn good when he
came
out.
And this is why certain pitchers, they're dominant, but they're designed, Ted, for about 20 to 30 pitches. Go over that, and you go into uncharted territory. Just get that sense right now, Caden Brister. How much does he have left in him? I think St. Pete's going to try and ride him out here, but I'm not sure he has his best stuff left.
Well, they're going to leave him in, so the end of that tale is before you.
I believe we're going to have a pinch hitter here for Daytona State.
The batter, third baseman, number one,
Charlie Pellicer. We'll get the nod here. So Charlie Pellicer, he's got a base hit today. Swings at the first pitch.
Good pitch there, just a little bit up in the strike zone. Brister right down the pipe with that one.
Charlie Pellicer could have a future as a coach. Coach Tuma says, so intelligent, finds ways to help the team. Hits it hard this time to the shortstop. Long throw over to first. And that is not happening. Daytona State able to score again. So the Falcons make it 12-2, and that is going to do it. Daytona State will win with the 10-run rule today here in their first game against St. Pete College. The Falcons, all gas, no brakes, right. Did not let up, and they get out of here and six Ladies innings. And incredible.
This game is now wow.
I know. I'm glad we started talking about that, Drew, just a little while ago, so that way the fans know what's going on.
So the 10-run rule put into effect. Figured we'd maybe get to the seventh. No need, as Daytona State gets three more in the sixth. And they walk off 12-2 winners here on WDSC-TV. What a way to start baseball season here in the spring of 2024.
Yeah.
Daytona State impressive today. Hey, we invite you to hit us up on social media at DSC Falcon Sports on Twitter, Daytona State College Athletics on Facebook, and on Instagram at DSC Falcon Sports. Ted Sofianos, final thoughts, Professor. What have you got for us?
Well, it was just a juggernaut of offense for Daytona State, and their pitching looked pretty darn good. I mean, the bats came alive a little bit there for, you know, the Titans, but just not enough. Too much pressure put on by that incredible offense. And obviously the same names being mentioned in that offense over and over again, Drew.
Yeah, tremendous performances today by the lineman of Daytona State. Nate Cannizzaro was absolutely outstanding, just swinging a mean bat. And then the pitching staff, I think, really picked it up. Bryce Roth on one hand, Wyatt Mummert came in relief in that fifth inning. And when he got it going,
yes,
there was just no chance for St. Pete today.
And I was telling you, when he was warming up, when Mummert was coming in, right, I said, he doesn't waste much time. And I tell you, it was just kind of like a buzzsaw coming at the plate. And he even bailed himself out when he had two men on base for a little while there back in the fifth inning. He really showed his stuff.
An impressive day for Daytona State College. They improved to 12-10 on the season, and they get ready to head now to St. Pete's backyard. They're going to go to Clearwater, play two at Jack Russell Stadium on Saturday, and look forward to swinging by the ballpark and maybe catching some of that game. Hope you enjoyed our broadcast, everybody. It certainly was fun on a beautiful day here in Daytona Beach. Bike week being celebrated. And baseball, bike week and baseball, it goes hand in hand.
Never going to see that again, I don't think. Very rarely. All right.
So many good things to look forward to in the future here on campus. We've got a couple softball broadcasts and more baseball coming your way here in the coming months on WDSC-TV. Until then, for Ted Sofianos, I'm Drew Felios. Daytona State getting it done on the mound and at the plate. The Falcons take care of business against St. Pete. There you look at the cast of characters, all the great folks behind the scenes who make it happen, who make us look and sound good. Our great crew at WDSC-TV, once again delivering a top-notch broadcast. Until next time, everybody, for Ted Sofianos, I'm Drew Felios. We will see you later. Have a great week.